This tutorial will show you how to make this video by editing the countdown paint action sequence that we made in the last video. So the first thing I want to do is to bring in a new source video. I'll just drag and drop this new source video. Now I'll play this paint action sequence that we made in the last video. This looks like it works, as is, on this source video. But we are going to edit this paint action sequence to use a different background video, and make a few tweaks to the other steps as well. The first step is to replace the countdown background video. Just as before, I will choose, Action, Paint Action Sequence Timeline. Record context, and then choose multiple keys and finally content. And then choose a new movie. I'm going to choose this movie that was made in Studio Artist using the interactive dual paint mode with a preset called Hypno. In the next video of this series, I'm going to show you how to make this background video using the interactive dual mode and streaming out to a movie. Now that I recorded a new content context step, I'm going to delete the old countdown movie by highlighting its step and deleting it. Then I'll bring the new background movie up to the top of the paint action sequence. Now it looks like this. I'm now going to edit the first vectorizer step. Notice that when I click on the red square that it selects and plays the step, but it also changes the mode. So, if I click this step it will change to the vectorizer mode, and if I click on this auto paint step it will change to the paint synthesizer mode. I'm going to bring back this vectorizer step, and then toggle to the vectorizer editor, because I want to change the colors here. In the drawing panel I can see that the outline color option is using the fix color source, which is this orange square in the source area. I can change the color by double clicking on the source color, which will then bring up the color wheel. Since I now changed the color, I'm going to save that change by holding down the option key on Mac or the Alt key on Windows and clicking on the red square. I'll just step play these back. The other thing I want to change is this white outline. I want to change the region outline to a darker region color, and I also want to make the outline a little wider. I'll click action to see the results. So I like that. So once again I will option click on the Mac or Alt click on Windows to save the changes. The last thing I want to do is change the compositing. Compositing is really powerful in Studio Artist and I really encourage you to play around with it. I'm going to change the compositing to Edge 3. It does this effect. Now I'll save that edited step again by option clicking or alt clicking the red square. The next step is this auto paint fill. I want to change the shape as well as the fill. So again notice, when I click on the red square next to the auto paint step, the mode changes to the paint synthesizer. I'm going to go to path shape in the editor to change the shape of the brush nibs by choosing spiral one. These are a little small, so what I'll do is lengthen the path a little more. I also want to change the color, which is in the paint color source panel. I'm going to change from white only, to fix color memory 2, and then I will save that by option clicking, or alt clicking on the step. With the next step, I want to bring in more detail to the vector outline. So I'll click on the vectorizer step. Then in the generation panel, I will change the pause negative threshold by giving it a larger number, and then undo the last step, and click action. That looks good, so I'll save this step. I'm going to add one more step, which will be a white outline in the vectorizer. I'll choose the sketch presets in the vectorizer and choose the white outline thin preset and click action. That's good. But I also want to show you how to add a second sketch element in the compositing panel. I'm going to choose this one called Source Edge. I'm also going to change the color to white, and then click action. I like that, but I want the lines a little straighter, so I'm going to choose a smart edge effect. There are a lot of different effects that you can apply to the sketches. I'm going to choose a poly simplify that should straighten the lines out a little bit. That looks good, but I forgot to record it, so I will check record and click action again. Next I'll save the new paint action preset. To save a paint action sequence preset, Hold down Control on the Mac or right-click on Windows and mouse down in the Paint Action Sequence Editor window. Then choose Export, Paint Action Sequence Preset, and then save in your Favorites Preset folder. Now we have a finished paint action sequence, so we just need to output it by choosing Action, Process with a Paint Action Sequence, and then Source to Movie. Then just name the movie. Here's the final output. The next short tutorial will show you how to make the background movie used in this tutorial using movie streaming.